use of Linux systems has gone up tremendously for past few years. The main reason behind that is Linux is open source by default, and now Java, PHP as well as .NET programs can be hosted into Linux system. So it has become very important for developer community or system admins to understand how Linux works. But the main difficulty with the Linux was always that Linux was command based. But recently, graphical user interface has been introduced into Linux as a concept. But the problem is that by default it is not enabled in Linux systems. So I am going to show you how to install graphical user interface in Linux systems, and I am using Azure for showing this demo. You can find the similar steps for AWS as well. So I created virtual machine here, and now I am trying to connect this Linux machine through RDP, remote desktop program of Windows, and it is not connecting. There may be multiple reasons for that. One of them is that the default port for RDP is not enabled, or maybe firewall is blocking it. So I will open the default port, that is 3389 for RDP. If you are learning, this is cheap, but it is better that you disable all the firewall rules, incoming rules, so that you don't face confusion. But for this demo purpose, we may need to disable only 3389 and 22. 3389 is used for RDP, and 22 is used for SSH to connect through putty like programs. So initially, when you are trying to install GUI, you have to use command line. For that, you have to connect your system using putty or any SSH tool. Being Linux, being command based is actually in many ways blessing. So when you don't need a heavy program installed on your server unnecessarily, when you are well versed with command lines, you may not need to install GUI. But a lot of people are not aware with the exact commands. So they install GUI, graphical user interface, into their system so that they can see and do whatever they want. So because I am more familiar with AWS, I by default tried EC2-user. That may not work here because it is a AWS, not a AWS, it's a Azure machine, Azure virtual machine. So I should use the user which I have created while I was creating the machine. So that for me it is rdadmin. That or you can use, if you have not created the particular user, you can reset the password for root user, and you can use that root user for your purpose. Now I am going to show you how to run the actual commands and install the GUI. It is better to change to super user mode, and you can use sudo su command for that, and after that you can run your commands to install GUI. The good thing is that the smarter people have done bigger work for us already. So we have the commands available on the internet, and we can grab that, those commands, and run directly, and our work is done. We disabled firewall from Azure portal, and to avoid the confusion, you can disable the firewall from your system as well, from your Linux system, through command. And later, when your work is done, you can enable the firewall rules as per your requirement. These commands will install GUI in your system, but even after that you may not be able to connect to your system directly through RDP, because there are few more things which need to be done for that, and those are very small things, but people miss them, and small things become bigger problem. What are those things? Those things are rebooting the system. So after installing your program, please reboot the system, and as I said earlier, change the password of the root user, set the password which you can remember. after rebooting, sometimes firewall rules may reset. So, if you are not able to connect the system, please disable firewall through command line again. Ideally, it may not be required, but if it is a problem, you can try to do that. We are almost done, and now when we go to connect to RDP, as we saw earlier that when we were trying to connect to our system through RDP, it was not connecting and it was showing error, but now when I connect, it will show us the graphical user interface that is installed on it. And here it is. Now it's showing, and thank you for being with me. Thanks for your time.